हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे माय टॉपिक ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन इज फ्रैक्टल एनालिसिस ऑफ रिमोटली सेंस्ड इमेजेस। सो फॉर अ इंट्रोडक्शन, फ्रैक्टल मॉडल्स हैव बीन यूज्ड इन वैरायटी ऑफ इमेज प्रोसेसिंग एंड पैटर्न रिकॉग्निशन एप्लीकेशंस। फ्रैक्टल कैरेक्टराइजेशन ऑफ द रफनेस ऑफ रिमोटली सेंस्ड इमेजेस हैज बीन कंसिडर्ड यूजफुल एज अ पार्ट ऑफ मेटाडाटा of images or as tools for data mining or change detection. Applications of fractal techniques to image analysis rely heavily on estimation of fractal dimensions. The fractal dimension, often denoted as D, is a key parameter to develop in fractal geometry to measure the irregularities of complex objects. The purpose of this presentation is to provide a survey of commonly used methods of estimating fractal dimensions and their application to analysis of remotely sensed images. Fractals, self-similarity and fractal dimension. Many important features and patterns of nature are so irregular that classical Euclidean geometry is hardly of any help in describing their form. Mandelbrot generalized and expanded on Richards' 1961's empirical finding and showed that the relationship between length and measuring scale can be described by power law, which is as you can see on the screen, where D is called the fractal dimension and K is the constant. Also, topology cannot discriminate between crooked lines and straight lines. As such, part of the information about the form of irregular objects is necessarily lost in topological representations. Thus, in fractal geometry, on the other hand, dimension is treated as continuum. The use of fractal power in the description of complex shapes compensates in the effect of length of area lost because of all details is smaller than the measurement scale D. Fractal dimensions can be thought of as a measure of object's ability to fill the space in which it resides. A smooth line of D1 will approach D2 when it becomes so complex that it effectively takes up the whole plane. Similarly, as a surface D approaches the upper value of 3, it will appear increasingly rugged and display a rapid succession of peaks and values. Self-similar objects are isotropic upon rescaling. If rescaling of an object is anisotropic, then object is said to be self-affine. Formally, with self-affine fractals, the variation in one dimension direction scales differently than the variation in other direction. Thus, fractal geometry has also been applied to several diverse fields as metrology, ecology, material science, urban landscape, economics, finance, soil sciences, and medicine. Methods to compute the fractal dimension of an image intensify surfaces. The fractal dimension of a strictly self-similar object can be derived mathematically from the equation given by D is equal to log nr upon log 1 upon r, where nr represents an object of nr parts scaled down by a ratio of r. The D derived from the equation is called shape similarity dimension. A large number of methods have been proposed to compute the fractal, monofractal, which is dimension of natural objects. These methods differ in the way they approximate the quantity nr in the equation, but they are similar in spirit in that they use some variations of a statistical relationship between the measured quantities of an object and step sizes to derive the estimate of D. A remotely sensed image can be viewed as a highly terrain surface whose elevation is proportional to the gray level or digital number Dn,
As such, all methods developed to compute the d of a surface feature can in principle be readily applied to remotely sensed images. There are many methods to calculate d. One of them is a triangular prism method. This method makes use of raster representation of elevation of Earth's surface, such as in digital elevation model DEM. As you can see, the 3D view of triangular prism method from the Clark's 1986 general. The second B figure, you can see the top view of corner pixels A, B, C, and D and center point E used in Clark's 1986 method, which we can see further. Talking about the different methods to compute the fractal dimension D of surface features. So we have seen triangular method before, and talking about the other methods, there are differential box counting, which uses the relation of number of boxes needed to cover an image versus box size, and variogram, which uses the relation of mean squared elevation or DN difference versus the distance. Isratium, which uses length of contour lines versus step size. Robust fractal estimator, which uses length of profile versus step size. And power spectrum, which uses Fourier power spectrum density versus the frequency. We can see the fractal dimension of a contour line is denoted by D contour, and the fractal dimensions of a profile is represented by D profile in the figure for the formulas used. The differential box counting method. Talking about the second method, in the differential box counting method, NR equation given below is counted in the following manner. If an image of size m cross m pixels is scaled down to s cross s, where m by 2 is greater than equal to s, which is greater than 1, and if s is an integer, then we have the ratio of r is equal to s upon m. If we consider the image as 3D space with x and y denoting the image plane and z denoting the gray level, the xy space is partitioned into grid of size s cross s. On each grid, there is a column box of size s cross s dash. Taking contributions from all the grids, we have nr is equal to summation of nr from I to j. Despite this, the method does not seem to have been widely applied to remote sensing problems, which we will see further. Variogram method. In this method, the mean of the squared elevation dn and difference is calculated for different distances, and d is estimated from the slope given in the figure below of the regression between the logarithms of variance and distance, so that d is equal to 3 minus b by 2. First, the method can be applied to both regular and irregular data, and secondly, for irregular polygon data, the variogram functions can be determined by centroid's representation of polygon. Third, we can compare this with Isratium methods. The variogram method is generally more reliable. As you can see in the figure, there is a log of variance versus log of distance plot used in the variogram method. Applications of fractal techniques to remote sensing images and analysis. There is a large amount of literature on applications of fractal techniques to analyze remotely sensed images, and the main thrust on this PPT is the use of D to measure the roughness of textural complexity of land surface features. Here the focus is on four major areas that is used to compute the D. to characterize the overall spatial complexity of an image and to supply image classification with textural information to describe the geometric complexity of space of feature class into classified image and to image examine the scaling behavior of environmental phenomena. Are remotely sensed images fractal? You might be thinking this question till now after watching the PPT. So, the self-similar property underlying the fractal model predicts that for truly fractal surfaces, the computed D should be constant at all scales, at all locations, and at all directions. Studies directly addressing this issue appear scarce. Nevertheless, a number of studies have been found that estimated D of real remotely sensed images vary with the resolution of the image used and region and direction in which D was computed. It can be further noted that the log-log plots constructed in the study were non-linear beyond a certain range, thus indicating break in the slope of regression lines and hence the D. For example, the variogram method assumes that the surface being analyzed have statistical properties similar to those of fractal Brownian surfaces. After the above discussion suggests that there is still considerable uncertainty regarding to what extent remotely sensed images are statistical or self-similar, and which self-similarity is a prerequisite to apply fractal techniques. So, how to better describe image textures using fractal geometry? A major finding from some of the research published till date is that while fractal dimensions appear able to capture certain aspects of surface properties of remotely sensed images, use of D alone cannot satisfactorily describe the image textures and achieve satisfactory classification results. Several approaches have been suggested to address this problem. Below are some of the described approaches, which include multi-parameter fractal description of image textures, multi-fractal models, and linearity and image texture analysis. So, conclusion. Fractal techniques have been applied to measure the roughness or geometric complexities of the land surface features in unclassified and classified images. Despite the potential utility of fractal techniques, several methodological and practical measurement problems have been encountered in fractal analysis of remotely sensed image. For example, the computed D is supposed to capture the differences in characteristics of image textures. However, a host of factors other than image texture, such as computational methods used, the choice of input parameter values, input images, and so forth, many of all such effect on the computed D. A major drawback in such fractal techniques for analysis of remotely sensed images is that they can be applied only to a single bands. Since remotely sensed images are generally multispectral ones, it appears desirable to develop what may be called as multivariate fractal methods. Such multivariate fractal methods should enable the analysis of all brands together and therefore would represent a tremendous improvement to existing methods in fractal analysis of remotely sensed data. The fractal dimensions can be thought of as a summary statistic measuring the overall geometric complexities of image textures, like many summary statistics. The fractal dimensions is obtained by averaging the local tonal variation, and it only captures one aspect of spatial variations of gray level in the image. The references of this presentation are from Fractal Analysis of Remotely Sensed Images, A review and method, a review of methods and application by Wang Sun et al. And from International Journal of Remote Sensing. Thank you.